Now on Pet Corner, vet nurse Marie Yorston from VetCare Unitech joins me to look at why a rabbit might just be the perfect pet for you and your family. Morning, Marie.
Hi.
So you are a rabbit owner, I take it?
Yes, I am.
How many rabbits have you got?
I've got two rescues.
What are your bunnies called?
Willow and Winston.
Oh, nice names. Yeah. I like that. Do rabbits make good pets?
They make great pets, yeah. They're very inquisitive and social. They get up to a lot of mischief and, yeah, they're a really good pet to
have. You can actually free range them around your home, can't you?
Yes, you can, yeah. So I encourage owners to have, let them sort of have time out of their hutches and enclosures and things like that. A lot of the hutches that are commercially made for rabbits are way too small for rabbits to actually live in. So a lot of people are moving towards like free ranging and just letting them have like sort of rabbit-proofed areas around the house or even like building like big Wendy houses for them.
Wow.
To live in. Yeah.
I had no idea they were too small. So would you free range your bunny inside or outside or a bit of both?
You can do both. It's still really important for them to get some time outside to get some of the sunlight as well so they can have access to grass and things like that. But it's not always optional for some owners, but having them inside with a sort of safe environment that they can run around in, that you've got all rabbit proofed and everything.
And you can toilet train them?
Yes, you can, yeah.
That's cool.
So they're really easy to litter train. Yeah.
So are they easy to care for?
They are probably one of the most high maintenance pets to have.
Right.
Yeah. You will find hay in a lot of places around your house. You have to brush them a lot building those bonds with them as well is really important. If you're not spending enough time with your rabbit and you're just sort of leaving it in its enclosure all the time, then they tend to not bond well with you because they just see you as a threat.
They can get quite antisocial.
Yeah, yeah. So it's really important that we spend a lot of time with them so that they aren't afraid of us. And when they have that bond and relationship with us, they're absolutely amazing. They jump on the couch with you.
Aww.
And like for pets and everything.
What happens if you're not getting like a little bunny, like mm-hmm. a baby bunny? What happens if you're getting like rescue bunnies? How do you mm-hmm. bond with them?
I just spend a lot of time with them. Yeah, yeah. It's just building that trust and relationship with them, really. Yeah.
Do you need to vaccinate them?
You do need to vaccinate them.
What
yes,
sort of things do they need to be vaccinated against?
So there's a virus called Khaleesi virus in New Zealand. Mm-hmm. There are a few different strains of the virus at the moment. So there was one that was released back in the 90s,
right.
Which we have a current vaccine for. They've just recently released a new strain of that virus, the K5 virus. And there is some sort of cross protection from the initial vaccine, but they've just also recently found a new virus in Marlborough.
Right.
So I think MPI are working in getting vaccines into New Zealand at the moment. So it's really just important to get in touch with your vet to
see make what's
sure.
available and what you can do.
Yeah.
What about diet? What do you feed them?
So there's a huge misconception around diet from our children's storybooks and that, from like reading Peter Rabbit and everything.
Don't they just eat carrots?
Exactly. So carrots are actually not the best thing for bunnies. You can give them a small little treat. But the majority of their diet should really be hay and grass. That should make up sort of 80 to 90% of their diet. Things like vegetables and things like that should make up sort of 15% of their diet.
Dandelions? Can
yep.
they have dandelions?
Yeah, so that green diet is really good to incorporate that sort of natural forage of their diet. So dandelions, poha, all that kind of stuff. And then just a small amount of pellets and things like that, but real high quality pellets.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what are these here that you've got there? What's that?
Oh, those are little treats that a lady in New Zealand makes. They're called Binky Balls.
Binky Balls.
Yeah.
That is very cute.
And they are actually made of really high fibre pellets, and she dehydrates flowers and sort of coats them in like colourful flower petals like roses and hibiscus. And my rabbits go nuts for them.
They look cute for you and they look cute for Bunny too. So, and they also, oh, look at that. They like to have little knives.
Yeah, that's Willow dreaming.
How long does a rabbit live for roughly?
So the life expectancy will differ between breeds. Your smaller breeds, of course, can live longer, but sort of a life expectancy can be anywhere from sort of 8 to 12 years.
Oh, wow, that's longer than I thought. Okay.
Yeah, rabbits are living a lot longer now because owners are sort of being more involved in their care and what we're feeding them as well. We used to see rabbits only sort of live until maybe 3 at the oldest, and that was just due to sort of incorrect diet and housing and
Excellent. Just like humans really. Hey Marie, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And if you would like more great pet care advice or vet services, check out the team at VetCare via their website, unitech.vetcare.net, rather, .nz.